Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today I, Priyanka Agrawal, am going to be talking about whether the education system in India is in sync with the country's current needs. According to an article posted by Reader's Business in 2010, India, the 1.1 billion people nation, currently has 600 million people below 25 years of age, out of which only 320 million are in schools and colleges, less than 25% of which are employable. Yet when speaking to Indian corporates, talent search seems to be their biggest challenge. Are we a nation of educated but unemployable? Today the process of education is considered so important that no parent wants to leave his or her child uneducated. For those who cannot afford to give their children a formal education, their governmental and non-governmental organizations, literary groups, etc., who are doing their bit to have them covered. Overall, education is a top priority for us Indians. The government has now enacted laws making primary education a fundamental right and has allotted huge budgets for the education of the underprivileged. According to the current census report by the Government of India, we now have some states that even boast of a 90% literacy rate. Most of the states faring reasonably high on this benchmark. Some of India's universities are now respected on a global level and are best in class. The competitiveness in our higher education system is notorious, yet our students manage to cope and come out with flying colors, with each passing batch scoring higher than their predecessors. Indian students are sought after by universities all across the world. Indian students have now established a global reputation of intelligence, which is simply amazing. So then the next obvious question to ask is why India also boasts of one of the highest populations of the unemployed. A basic comparison of graduates versus those that gain meaningful employment in their areas of academic specialization reveals startling facts. The educated are not deemed to be employable. This seems to smash every myth that we've all grown up with, where we've learned that an education is a gateway to a good job. During my summer internship, I happened to meet with the human resources manager of the company that I worked for. She seemed to be completely frustrated with the shortage of good, employable people. Despite having several impressive resumes on her desk, most graduates that she would interview simply failed to meet the requisites for the job at hand. I was intrigued by what she said to me. On a rather casual note, I must admit, so many educated and yet unemployable people in this nation. This led me to think. The more I thought about it, the more I began to realize that our education system is just not keeping pace with the changing needs of our nation or the working environment. I was convinced that we all live in a state of denial without wanting to once sit up and take note of this reality. We all feel that this applies to our neighbors and not to ourselves. We're convinced that our children will not face the same consequences as the millions who end up doing jobs that are completely contradictory to their academic skills. We also seem to feel too small to even start to think of a change. After all, how can I change the education system of an entire nation? This complacency, coupled with the political leadership that seems to have its motivations rooted in personal wealth creation, is going to blow up into a problem of magnitudes that we best not imagine. Millions and millions of educated and unemployed, the consequences of this to civic society cannot even be imagined. Ladies and gentlemen, for the sake of our future generations, we need to act now. We need to stand up and take responsibility to become the agents of change. We need to make our voices heard in the corridors of policymakers to ensure that they put their ears against the needs of the young generation. We need to press for reforms in our academic system, and we need to do this today. Our education system and curriculum needs to be made more employment-centric rather than dedicating itself solely to the purpose of academic theory, most of which is anyways available at the click of a button today. More importantly, this process needs to start from a primary school stage and not just at university levels. After all, we know the number of children that drop out of basic schooling. Wouldn't it be much more productive if these children could gain meaningful employment? Looking around, we find that children up to high school are intensely focused on one agenda, scoring the highest grades in their board examinations. Competitiveness to enter good colleges has created intense competition amongst this young generation to the point where children have foregone all other aspirations and talents in pursuit of their prescribed academic curriculum. As a consequence, the academic system seems to now revolve around the art of memorizing every page of a textbook and practicing on every past sample paper from the past 10 years. It appears that the student with the best memory is now the winner. We truly need to step back and think for ourselves if this is indeed the future. In a world where professional opportunities have expanded much beyond management, medicine, and engineering, we need to stop and retrospect the system. Shouldn't the schooling system be designed to bring out the best in every child? To help the child recognize and exploit their nature, talent, and aspirations? Shouldn't we be preparing children for the real world rather than an admission into university? So where have we gone wrong? We've gone wrong in several ways, and we need to work on rectifying the same now. If not for ourselves, then for our future generations. Firstly, our high school system seems to be designed to prepare students to score for college admissions. The entire education process is orientated to board exams and high scores. Students are therefore under tremendous pressure to focus only on this one dimension. Memorize all the textbooks. The benchmark for success has become good grades. It has been drilled into children that the future is bright only if one scores well in the board exams. After all, this would open doors to a good university and which will then open the doors to a successful career. This needs to change. Schools need to focus on working with children to help identify the unique skills, talents, and aspirations of every child. Schools also need to explain to students the various opportunities available to children today, as against a decade ago. Schools then need to work with each child in a unique manner to ensure that each child then flourishes in the realm of his or her own skills and talents. This will lead to a more talented and motivated group of children coming out of schools. The focus needs to shift from top grades to skill development and preparation for the real world. Secondly, our university system needs to change. Universities are orientated towards a theoretical curriculum with the sole objective to ensure that each student is loaded with knowledge prescribed in a curriculum. Universities are completely disconnected to the real world needs. Employers and universities do not seem to be on the same page. As a consequence, students that come out of universities are not prepared for real jobs. Universities therefore need to start thinking differently. Academic curriculums need to be reorientated towards real-time skills required in the real world. Universities need to engage with the corporate or professional world to ensure that they train rather than teach, and start generating children that can plug and play in a real-time environment. Thirdly, our social and academic environment seems to be orientated towards three major professional careers: management, medicine, and engineering. This needs to change, and we need to also understand that the world today offers many more choices of careers, including and not limited to performing arts, sports, and leadership development. We need to enable social and political consensus around this reality and start accepting the new realities. Once social acceptance is provided for these new areas of profession, this will in itself motivate children to pursue the same with confidence. Politically, our government needs to start giving equal importance to these other facilities and start directing policy, if not resources, towards this new need. We need to create world-class institutions for all fields of professional development. Lastly, we need to understand that we are living in the knowledge economy, where the most valuable resource is knowledge and intellectual property. Here, we need to motivate our education system to pursue new knowledge and not simply focus on the knowledge of the past. Students need to be motivated to challenge every claim that has been made and led and ask, is there a way better? This will lead to the beginning of creativity and a nation of thinkers. We can create a society of innovation rather than one of repetitiveness and complacency. After all, look around you. The most successful people in the world today are those that brought new knowledge to the world. Finally, I'd like to end with a video.